Hello. So lately I've been doing a lot of shooting, as you've noticed with my videos. I'm still doing a lot of bushcraft, survival and such, I'm still teaching, and I'm working a full-time job. Today, I turned 57. It's my birthday. So, I thought I'd bring out the Gamo Varmint Air Rifle. Now this here, I haven't shot it a whole lot, and it said that you should put about 200 rounds or so through it, just to improve the accuracy. They say you gotta break in the barrel, basically. Now I've got some old pellets here. We're gonna have some fun shooting at a target back there and see if I can get any kind of accuracy at all. I had it tuned in, I thought, at one point, but I had it out the other day and I was shooting high. So it almost seems like every time I go out, I gotta readjust my scope. We'll find out. But that could be due to me not shooting it very often. That could be it. I gotta break in the barrel. Gonna try that first. So when I first came here, there was not a sound, and now all I hear is traffic noise about a half kilometer out that way, and you're pointed this way, so hopefully you don't hear it too loud. I hear it rather loud right where I'm at right now. But the story behind this is I researched it. Can you hunt with air rifles in Canada? Yes, you can. I guess it's in Ontario, not New Brunswick. So I bought this because I thought it'd be an inexpensive way to go small game hunting. But this is also classed as a firearm. Anything over 500 feet per second is classed as a firearm. So I gotta use a trigger lock, I can't have my pellets, you know, stored with this. All those laws, firearm laws, apply to this air rifle. And I'm not able to hunt in my province with this. I thought it would have been nice to be able to go rabbit hunting or partridge hunting with this, but I'm able to now, which kind of was a bummer for sure. Now, it's a target rifle. I don't normally shoot just target. I sight in my firearm, and then I hunt. I don't normally waste ammunition. At least this is cheap. So today, I've got a clipboard with some paper. I'm gonna draw on a few marks and have some fun plinking with this thing today. So have fun watching. So this here is a breakdown. Break it down like that there. Put your pellet in. So it is not fast at all. And there is actually a safety on this as well. So I'm not gonna do a review. I got a mosquito eating at my knuckle. Not gonna review on this thing. I just wanna do some firing and thought I'd bring you with me. So I have started using a cool rig for my target practice out here in the bush. I don't go to a range. I target practice in a safe area in the bush. So I'm going to show you what I've been using to set up my targets and stuff, and it's been working pretty darn sweet. So this here is a dollar store clipboard. This allows me to be able to hang it on a branch, you know, or set it on the ground at the base of a tree and so on. I can change the paper as needed, but as you see, and it's been a couple flyaways as well. So I can just put on the paper here, put one on at a time, and just start shooting. I mean, it's held together pretty good. And as long as I'm putting it through the middle, it can last me years. So I'm gonna set this up. Let's take some shots. I'm gonna take three shots and then we're gonna take a look at it. there's the shots. That's my first one. That was my second. And right there is my third. Right there. So that's at about 10 yards. That still isn't too bad. I could definitely get game with that there. But we're going to fire some more and see if it improves after, you know, a few more rounds. Now you can see where those three hit, low and to the right. I did not adjust anything. Let's take three more shots. The grouping right there, and you see it's all off to this side. One or two. I had three actually hit here, but that's where they were every time I shot. So I am going to bring it over just a hair and see if that does help. I'll bring it over a hair and bring it up. I'm going to also make another X and start with that. Just so we have new holes. Actually, no holes. Not new holes. Until I fire. But this thing here, of course, takes a little bit longer to load and so on. But it, you know, is working nice, really. I'm shooting into a dead tree stump right there, and I'm not filling a live tree full of lead. Okay, so I'm gonna change up the paper. I could move it to another spot. Maybe I'll just move it up and try it there first, or actually I just move it down a little bit just so I have I can use more of this paper. Wasn't too bad at all. It was right here and right here. That last one basically shot over here, but that's as the wind flipped the page. So what I did is I turned both dials about a quarter turn, and I think I might have it dialed in. I'm gonna try a few more without the paper flipping in the wind and see what happens. There's the three shots. One, two, and the third's over here. Now I'm also freestanding, just leaning against the tree, just for a little bit of stability. So if I was on a bench and such, it may make a whole lot of difference. There could be a little bit of a human error here. Although, that's pretty darn good. I'm very happy with that, for sure. Now, if you've made it to this part of the video, I'm going to fill a bottle of water and shoot it and see if there's any kind of kinetic energy with this that is going to actually make it fly in the air or whatever. Let's see how this does by hitting a bottle of water. I'm kind of curious. So that was an interesting test. You can see that's where they went in, but they're in the bottom here. They flattened right out, but they did not go all the way through. The water actually stopped them. But it did not jump or move, it just went in. And as you see, I'm gonna look at that lead. Now this is supposed to go 1250 feet per second, but that's with alloy pellets, not with lead. So I'm not sure what I'm getting, but this is still rather powerful. It, you know, it just squished those. Water, you know, that's has to have a lot of energy. I was kind of curious what it would do, and now we know. I'm gonna put the last three in here, and I'm doing it freehand. There's one, two to go. I know it drifted just as I pulled the trigger. And if these are not right on, I'm gonna blame it because I haven't used enough ammo yet. Actually shooting pretty decent right now. I find it a lot harder to aim at a target just because you're trying to get that perfect shot, so and then you're waving back and forth. Where if that was a rabbit or something, you just pull up, aim for the center and pull. So, I'll show you what that looks like. So, before I demonstrated this and before I shot the bottle, they were right here. All those, really nice. That is those ones there. And I don't know, they were pretty close when I pulled the trigger, so still, it's not a bad grouping. They're within, you know, an inch from the center. So that would all be, you know, game getters. That's the one there that I actually had it drop on me when I pulled. But see, that always bugs me. I'm gonna do off camera five more, and I'm gonna take my time and actually see how this is shooting. So there it is. That's my last grouping right there. All five shots, all within that. And that's basically a 1-inch by 1-inch cross. So, working very good, actually. I was doing it freehand. Maybe I was pulling a little bit, you know. But it is working rather decent. So, hopefully you had fun. I mean, I'm out here just plinking around. It's a good way to spend a birthday for sure, breaking in that air rifle. But if I had to get game right now the way it's shooting, I would be able to count on that air rifle to get small game if I needed to. Although, I'm not allowed. Have a good one. Take care. Thanks for watching.